presents another episode of Historic Murgatroyd, where we explore important persons in past Murgatroyd history. Tonight we are looking at the early 20th century writer Gadsden Colbin, who left his literary mark on Murgatroyd and the rest of the nation. A look back at a true literary great, tonight here on Historic Murgatroyd with your host Led Stuffgowl.
Led Stuffgowl here, your host for another episode of Historic Murgatroyd. Tonight, we continue with the second installment of the literary genius, the 20th century literary great, Gadsden Colbin. Colbin's divorce in 1906, along with his failure to get anything he had written up to that time published, sent him into a severe state of depression. His sister Judiana described his conditions and actions during that bleak period.
He was seemingly irrevocably distraught. It was as if hope itself had crumbled away at his fingertips. I watched him stare at a deserted cemetery across from our cottage for ungodly lengths of time. It was not unusual for him to forego the typical social amenities. When he ate, if he did so at all, he would use his bare hands and tear at the food viciously. We would, at times, erupt into horrid rage and throw chairs or books or dishes across the dining room. Fearing his uncontrollable wrath, I would silently clean up after him. Only after I felt he had sufficiently calmed down would I dare speak to him, and then only in the least provocative of terms. He continued to write, of course, but he took great pains to conceal his stories from me. There was a brief time when I feared that he was becoming paranoid. He would insist that no one touch his desk, lest his stories be stolen. He locked and barred several of the windows, claiming he wished to prevent spies from invading our home.
It was 1907 before Dr. Colbin again assumed demeanor that might be deemed normal, if indeed there is such a thing. He met the eccentric young Dr. Kimmis at a small social gathering hosted by Judiana. They were later to collaborate on a number of nonfiction treatises. Many of these writings contain economic theories which long foreshadowed the pay your bills movement which Dr. Kimmis launched in the late 1930s. Colbin saw his first story published in 1911. Death of the Cursed Vultures was one of the first in its genre, and a trendsetter which had impact on stories for the next decade. Colbin continued to mail many of his stories to various correspondents with whom he corresponded.